I want to put the next question to Ravi Shankar Prasad because the BJP has been attributing a large part of the performance today to Narendra Modi. I just want to take a look at the vote share figures for Delhi. If we can have that up on our screen, please. Mr. Prasad, I want you to listen just carefully to the vote share figures. I'm sure you're aware of this already. I'm going to call for the Delhi overall vote share figures up on our screen. And if you look at these figures, the BJP, Mr. Prasad, largely has only succeeded in keeping its current vote share. It isn't as if they've been able to ride a big Modi wave or a big anti-Congress wave. Your vote share actually coming down 2% from the last elections. The Congress's vote share coming down 15%. It's AAP which is at 30, you're at 34. How do you explain the vote share percentages, Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad? Your vote share actually dipping from the last election. There's no big Modi wave that these votes reflect, sir.
I know this query makes you happy. Therefore, I have no problem with that, Rahul.
No, it doesn't make me happy at all. I must say, it doesn't make me happy at all. I'm just as a journalist doing my job and asking a question. It doesn't make me happy at all. These are the facts. I'm laying them out. I want an answer, sir. That's all.
Do I don't have the right to take a pun on you?
Oh, absolutely you do.
I think I have the right. My point is very simple. I am not for a moment minimizing the commendable performance of Aam Aadmi Party in their maiden venture. They were not there earlier. Therefore, I considered the very outset that if they would not have been there, our number would have been much, much there. But to say that Modiji's extraordinary campaign in Delhi has not been able to ensure BJP's this performance will be unfair, apart from all of us who have campaigned there. That's the point number one. And point number two, you are again pushing Modi ji only in Delhi or BJP only in Delhi. And if I say so, deliberately ignoring the extraordinary performance of Delhi.
We've broken this program into 6 half-hour segments. Just in the next segment, we're looking at whether there is a Modi wave in the Hindi heartland. We're also separately analyzing whether Rahul Gandhi has been a complete disaster. So we've broken this up. We're discussing each week separately. But I am interested in understanding from you your view on the significance of the projection of Harshvardhan. Do you concede if you'd gone in with Vijay Goyal, hadn't changed horses midway, that the Aam Aadmi Party might have possibly done even better than it has, Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad?
Well, that is not a fair way to say. The entire party combined together at the appropriate time, Harshvardhan decision was taken. It is entirely academic. If you would have done a little earlier, things could have been better. The facts are as they are. But since I will not be available for the other program because I am going to other channels, let me flag two issues to you. Since you are only confined to Delhi, but I would like your viewers to know that getting a nearly two-thirds majority in the third term under a quote-unquote United Congress under Sindhya, Jitendra Sindhya, is not a mean achievement. Having a three-fourths near majority in Rajasthan against quote-unquote the best government of Congress party in terms of equity is not a mean achievement. Chhattisgarh third term, reaching the same place in spite of Naxal problems and a whole lot of other problems, is not a mean achievement. And in Delhi, Sheila Dixit having been decimated in spite of a commendable performance by the Aam Aadmi Party, yet BJP emerging as the biggest party, very close to majority, is not a mean achievement.
Oh, no one can say for a moment that these are small achievements. These are massive successes for the BJP. There can be no dispute about it.